Hi everyone, and welcome to this new video on native Australian stingless bees. The other day my colleagues were splitting two colonies and I could not resist the opportunity to make a short video. So here we go.
Okay Naila, I'm ready for the split.
Ready? On the side here.
Oh, it's wonderful.
Cool, so it's splitted. So this is a young brood, this is an old brood. And we have a lot of pollen and honey around.
Yep, an awful lot of honey.
It's a huge brood, it's very spread and it's beautiful.
It's a beautiful brood.
Oh wow. Here there's one, so we can give this one to the top.
So now, the one that you're wanting is this one?
Oh, no, this one.
That's
I'll
right,
prefer to keep that one,
okay.
If you don't mind.
All right, so we need to M-lock this. So around here, like this area here would be honey. That would be a honey cell, the globe.
Yeah, all of them are kind of the same shape, the pollen and the honey.
So they actually store the pollen around the outside rather than on top. I could basically put the honey and pollen on top.
No, you can find on top of it as well.
Okay.
In my colony that I split the other day, so I have three layers. The top layer was only honey and pollen because we had like a separation in the honeybee's entrance.
Yeah.
So the brood was underneath there and it was full of pollen there.
Yeah.
And then honey.
No, it's not too hot, it's just that it's good. Oh, okay.
But also, you don't want to lose too many bees to your shop.
Yeah.
You don't want to lose all the forages. Look at they are going back there.
So the other one which we're going to split now as well, do you want to do that there or do you want to do that here?
Over there.
Okay. Okay. Yeah, these are these are much more aggressive.
Woo! Oh yes, really speed.
So that's the honey over there,
yeah.
Right? And that's the pollen.
Yeah.
And that's the brood.
Yeah.
And how do you recognize queen cells?
They are bigger and on the side. This one.
Okay.
Queen cells. This one here.
Okay.
This one.
Okay.
And this, do you see that? This is the old brood.
Yes.
And this is young brood is down there. There is a space.
Mm-hmm.
So
okay.
This is actually very good because we need to check that there is queen cell there and then we can do the same thing.
And
we
what about
to take this
drone cells? Can you
drone
identify cell, drone cells?
No, they're the same size. I have no idea the drone cells we have. But here the brood doesn't seem as healthy. There's a lot of holes. Maybe that's on purpose.
So Sean, it's perfect. We don't need to do anything. We can give this over to this one.
Yeah.
And these are a lot of queen cells.
So this one will go on top.
Yeah.
So I tried to put some propolis well sealed like this. That way they won't collapse.
Okay.
Because that's a risk. Because this collapses. But there are so many bees that straight away they will start to build little bridge.
Okay. So we just put this on top?
Yeah.
Look at that helix.
Thank you. So we thought, we see all that we could bring this one to relocate it far, far away, maybe near your apiary, or like at the bottom of this apiary. Should be far enough.
I think it's fine as long as it's stable.
Yeah, exactly. They'll seal it so quickly.
Yeah, they will.
Especially this time of the year.